Well, news now from Tamil Nadu and releasing what he calls the DMK files. Tamil Nadu BJP chief K. Annamalai today released a long list of assets worth 1.34 lakh crore rupees, which he claims is owned by key DMK leaders, including Chief Minister M.K. Stalin's son and Sports Minister Udayanidhi Stalin. And specifically targeting the Chief Minister M.K. Stalin, Annamalai alleged that he was paid a bribe of 200 crore for favoring a company to secure the contract for the Chennai Metro Rail ahead of the 2011 assembly elections. But responding to this, to these allegations, DMK MP R.S. Bharati has said this is a joke and there's no single allegation of payment of such a bribe. Well, let's go across to Sam Daniel for more. And Sam, so what did Mr. Annamalai really, you know, show in support of all these allegations, and tell us more about the DMK's response to this?
A bulk of Annamalai's list that he released today, Gargi, had list of properties owned by various senior DMK leaders, including Udayanidhi Stalin, Tamil Nadu Chief Minister M.K. Stalin's son, and many senior ministers and former central ministers. And that overall, he says, totals to 1.34 lakh crore rupees. And in terms of a specific allegation of payment of 200 crore bribe to M.K. Stalin during the earlier DMK tenure in Tamil Nadu for allegedly favoring a company to get the contract for the Chennai Metro Rail project, Annamalai says, through two shell companies, 200 crore rupees were routed to M.K. Stalin to fund the 2011 assembly by-elections. And for that, the DMK says, let Annamalai or the BJP prosecute us. We will fight in the court of law. They say there's not a shred of evidence, and over the last 9 years the BJP has been in power. If at all they found anything wrong, they ought to have filed by now, but they say we will face it. In terms of the other allegation of massive properties allegedly owned by DMK leaders, they say all the affidavits filed by these leaders, especially during election time, has the properties owned by them. And legally speaking, anybody who hides information in terms of not divulging the properties they own would be liable to even lose their elected position. And they challenge Annamalai in 2 weeks' time to give documentary evidence of the properties he alleges these leaders own. And they also claim that Annamalai has a kind of a blanket allegation, says DMK, the party, owns so many schools, colleges and universities. That's completely wrong, and they are also trying to challenge him legally after discussing at the party level. And today Annamalai also released a receipt for the 3 lakh worth of the watch, Dassault Aviation made watch he sports, saying that it was originally bought by his friend Sher Alauddin, from who he had paid 3 lakh rupees in 2021 May and bought that watch. This became an issue after a minister from Tamil Nadu had challenged Annamalai to produce the receipt for the purchase of that particular watch. And although today Annamalai had shown the receipt of that particular friend's original purchase, there was no proof given for him having paid money towards that purchase from that friend. And politically, this is being seen as an attempt by Annamalai preparing the BJP for the 2024 Lok Sabha elections. In the state, the party has a very negligible presence. They've managed to win 4 seats earlier in alliance with the AIADMK, with who too Annamalai is not comfortable alleging corruption by them, particularly during the recent bipoll to Erode East Assembly constituency. In an internal meeting, Annamalai had also spoken recently, saying that he would step down if the party high command decides to continue their alliance with the BJP. So he's calculating this kind of a revelation or allegation, in his words, called DMK files, could actually help the DMK to win more support, probably to win more seats in the upcoming elections. But the DMK says this will only help them to win more seats, and this will not affect their prospects even by a pinch, as that MP R.S. Bharati says, Gargi. But Annamalai would not take any questions. Right. He says he would take questions only after a week, giving time, as he calls, for journalists to verify the points he has made.